here we are, folks, in a 2020, 2021's around the corner. I know, like myself, many of you are so over it and ready to see what 2021 brings us. Today, you're gonna get some tangible, concrete steps that you can begin to take so that you don't fall into the pattern of not meeting your goals to make sure you follow through this year. So stick it out till the end of the video. I'm sure you'll get a lot out of this. Moving on. My name is Keisha Martin, and I'm a licensed therapist. If you're new and just stopping by, hi. This channel is devoted to all things mental wellness. So be sure you like and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on any of the videos. So let's get to it. So the first thing that I would encourage you to work on is your mindset. What do I mean by that? Well, I mean how you think about what you're trying to achieve. Have you tried to do this before and haven't seen it through? What are some potential obstacles in terms of how you talk to yourself when you're trying to achieve something? It's about how you frame your belief about what you're able to do and what you're able to achieve. So that's tip number one, challenge your mindset. Now, once your mindset's good and you're like, okay, you're centered, you're balanced, you're cool, I've got an idea what I need to do, then what you're gonna do is pretty elementary. You're gonna write it down and you're gonna put it somewhere where you can see it every single day. What is the reason for this? Well, it's a reminder. We get caught up in life and things and kids and family and friends and all the things. And oftentimes we have the attention span of a squirrel. So we can lose track and we can lose focus. But if you have it somewhere where you can see it regularly, you're going to have that constant reminder. And it's going to keep it in the forefront of your mind, which is going to help focus your energy to that particular thing. Before I move on, if you like this content and you're finding it helpful, be sure you like this video and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any more videos. Moving on. So you've worked on your mindset and you have written it down. So now the next thing is deadlines. And this is oftentimes where people get tripped up. They set a goal and they're like, yeah, in a year, this, or in 6 months, this. Okay. And then as time goes on, what can happen is, oh, I've got time. And then before you know it, that year's up and you haven't done anything. So instead of doing that, what I'm going to suggest and encourage you to do is to break it up into smaller chunks. So let's say you want to do 30 art projects this year. So instead of saying, oh, I'm going to do 30 projects this year, you're going to set a deadline of maybe one or two projects a month or every 2 months, however you want to frame it. You're holding yourself accountable if you break it down in chunks. So if you are able to accomplish one or two projects in a month, then what is that gonna do for you? You're gonna see it and you're like, oh yeah, I'm rocking it. I'm getting this done. That way you can acknowledge your progress and reinforce your efforts. Because we all need acknowledgement and we all need reinforcement, and we're not always gonna get that from other people, and we have to oftentimes provide that for ourselves and hold ourselves accountable. And then you know what's really cool about it is oftentimes you end up doing more than you initially planned on doing. So kick ass, take names. Anyway. Moving on. This one piggybacks on the previous one. You're going to reward yourself, okay? So you're going to acknowledge, you're going to reinforce, and then you're going to reward, okay? So let's say you did the one or two projects this month. You're going to acknowledge, you're going to be like, hey, I kicked ass, I got it done, right? Which reinforces, you know, the belief that you can do it, right? And then you're going to reward yourself for doing it. Okay, so what does that look like to you? Does that look like celebrating with a friend or a family member? Does that look like just checking it off on a little box? Does that mean you're gonna take a little trip? Like, you get to decide what your reward is for the efforts that you make. And it doesn't have to be anything monetarily. It can be just, you know, a day of self-care, for instance, or a day trip. You get to decide. But the reward part of it can make it actually a bit more appealing and a bit more motivating. So think about that. When it comes to goal setting, people can have a lot of different ideas on what works for them. So I definitely encourage you to just give this some thought, pick what works for you, what doesn't. Try to remain mindful of when you feel like you're making some progress and just kind of make a note of what's been working. When all is said and done, you're the expert in your life. If you missed my first video, then I would encourage you to go back and check that out. That might help you formulate and set your goals a bit better. I offer you some provoking questions to help you really solidify what it is that you're wanting to achieve. If you need some help and you struggle with maybe taking steps to move forward on meeting your goal, then that's where therapists might be able to help you. If you find yourself kind of stuck, then I would definitely encourage you to consider that. Now, I mentioned this briefly in my last video, If you do decide to go to therapy and you want some help propelling you forward or maybe identifying your goals, then it's important to keep the following in mind. Okay, when you go to a therapist, it's important to understand that your therapist doesn't have all the answers. We don't, okay? As much as I would like to have all the answers, I don't have all the answers, and no therapist does, okay? So don't go in expecting that this person is gonna be some wise guru and be like, oh, my child, this is what you gotta do, okay? It's not how it works. So keep that in mind if you decide to go to therapy. Also, we can't read your mind, okay? You gotta come in, you gotta share what's going on, what you're struggling with, what it is that you're feeling in order for us to really help you. So we can only go by what you share with us. If you're not completely forthcoming, then we're not gonna be able to help you the best way we can. And lastly, we cannot tell you what choices you have to make, okay? This is really important for you to understand. If you're coming to a therapist, we're going to listen, we're going to support, we're gonna encourage, we're gonna offer you some insight. We're gonna ask you some pretty deep questions to get your wheels turning, but it's up to you to make those connections and to decide what choice you're going to make as a result of those connections that you've made. So just keep that in mind. Well, I hope this content was helpful today. If you enjoyed this video, like it, subscribe to the channel, and until next time, be well, be strong, and be love.